Hello children, welcome to our maths class. So in our previous classes we have learned what is complementary, supplementary, adjacent and linear pairs. Complementary means when the sum of two angles is equal to 90 degrees then the angles are called complementary angles. Supplementary means the sum of two angles is equal to 180 degrees then that are called supplementary angles. Adjacent angle means the angles which have same common vertex and common arm are called adjacent angles. That means which have the common vertex and common arm are called adjacent angles. Next, linear pair. A pair of adjacent angles whose sum is 180 or straight line is called linear pair. Up to linear pair we have learned and up to linear pair exercise we have completed. That means up to exercise 6 we have completed. Next, before going to exercise 6 we have vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. When two lines intersect, the angle that are formed opposite to each other at the same point of the interior section are called vertically opposite angles. That means if the two lines are intersected at the same point, then these lines are called vertically opposite. So these two lines are called intersecting angles. When two lines are intersecting at the same point, these lines are called intersecting angles. And when the two angles, when the two lines are intersected at one point, then four angles are formed there. Four angles will form there. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then see here, after intersecting, here opposite, angle 1 is opposite to angle 3, angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. Now in the vertically opposite angles means, when the two lines are intersected at the same point, then four angles are formed. In that four angles, vertically opposite angles are equal. Vertically. Like this. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Now angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. Angle 1 is opposite to angle 3. If you assume angle 1 as 40 degrees, then both are opposite to each other and equal. Then angle 3 also 40. If angle 4 is 50 degrees, then angle 2 is also 50 degrees. That means when two lines are intersected at the same point, four angles are formed there. In that four angles, vertically opposite angles are equal. Then here you have to say that angle 1 is opposite to angle 3. So that's why angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Vertically opposite angles are equal. Then based on these vertically opposite angles, we have one exercise that is, now before going to exercise, now see in the textbook. Vertically opposite angles. When two lines intersect, the angles that are formed opposite to each other at the point of intersection of vertex are called vertically opposite angles. In the above figure, two lines L and M are intersected at O. Angle 1 is opposite to angle 3. Angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. Here angle 1, angle 3, angle 2, angle 4 are pairs of vertically opposite angles. Then which are, now observe this figure and you have to say which are vertically opposite to each other. Which are vertically opposite to each other in the adjacent figure. This is your homework. Write the here only. Next, do this. It is also. We can conclude that the vertically opposite angles are equal. Here, just now I said angle AOD is equal to angle BOC. Angle AOC is equal to angle BOD. Both are equal to each other. That means vertically opposite angles are equal. So, it is your do this. Complete right here. That means which are vertically opposite to each other. Which are opposite to, which angle is opposite to which angle. That means like this. Angle COD is opposite to AOF. CFOB opposite to BOC. Like that. Next, come to the exercise. Write, name two pairs of vertically opposite angles in the figure. Name two pairs of vertically opposite angles in the figure. Any two we have to write. Any two. Exercise 6. exercise 6, first bit. First question. Name two pairs of vertically opposite angles in the figure. I am not drawing the figure, just I'll draw like this. These are intersected. O, A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D, E. Now we have to find, name any two pairs of vertically opposite angles. Now, angle D, O, E. Sorry. Angle A, O, E. AOD is opposite to BOC. AOD is opposite to BOC. That means it is one pair. AOD, comma, BOC is one pair. Next another pair. Angle AOE opposite to angle AOC. Angle AOC is opposite to angle BOD. AOC, it is opposite to BOD. These are the two pairs of AOC is opposite to BOD. These are the two pairs of vertically opposite angles. Next, find the measure of X, Y and Z without actually measuring them. We have to find. Second question. Here I am drawing the figure. Here X, here Z, here Y, here it is 160 degrees they have given. Next, now find the measures of X, Y, Z. We have to find the value of X, Y, Z in the figure. And actually measuring them without measuring, we have to say how many degrees is X and Y and Z. Now how to say? See. Now, just now we have learnt about vertically opposite angles. Now these two lines are intersected at O. When two lines are intersected at the same point, vertically opposite angles are equal. Vertically opposite angles equal one time. But is angle Y is equal to angle Y and angle 160 are equal. So angle Y is equal to 160 degrees. That means, then right here based on vertically opposite angles are equal. So based on vertically opposite angles are equal, angle Y is equal to 160 degrees. Then we found angle Y that as 160 degrees. Now see Nana. And now this line is, if now it is angle 1 is 160 degrees. Now observe like this. When you observe here, it is like circle, straight line, straight line. Straight line means that is exactly 180 degrees. Now straight line means 180 degrees. Now see. Now this line becomes straight line. That means by adding X and Y, we should get 180 degrees. That means X plus Y is equal to 180 degrees. X plus, already we know Y. What is the value of Y? 160 degrees is equal to 180 degrees. By using simple equation, how to find the value of X? X is equal to 180 minus 160. X is equal to 180 minus 160 is 20 degrees. Now we got the value of X is 20 degrees. Then vertically opposite angles are equal again. So angle X is equal to angle Z. Angle X is 20 degrees. Then what about angle Z is also 20 degrees. So here we have to write angle X is equal to angle Z. So angle X is 20 degrees. So angle Z is also, both are 20 degrees. Like this. Angle Y is 160 degrees. Angle X and Z are 20 degrees. Y means base ram vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles equal ga untayi kabatti x and z are opposite to each other. So angle x is equal to 20, angle z is equal to 20. It is exercise 6. After exercise 6, directly we have transversal. Transversal line. What is mean by transversal? Transversal means if a line intersects two parallel lines at two distinct places, then that line is called transversal line. A line which intersects two or more, a line which intersects TRANS, transversal lines means a line which intersects two or more parallel lines at distinct places, then that line is called transversal line. A line which intersect two or more parallel lines at distinct places. A line which intersect two or more parallel lines at distinct places, then that line is called transversal line. Transversal line. Here L, M, N are three parallel lines. These three parallel lines are intersected by white line at distinct three points. So the intersecting line is called transversal line. This intersecting line is called transversal line. The name of this line is take as O. Take as K. K is the name of this transversal line is K. This transversal line K intersect L, M, N at three distinct places. So it is called transversal. Transversal line means a line which intersect two or more parallel lines at distinct places. Then that line is called transversal line. That line is called transversal line. A line which intersect two or more parallel lines at distinct places, then that line is called transversal line. Here L and M both are parallel lines. These two parallel lines are intersected by one line N at two places, here and here. That this intersecting line is called transversal line. A intersect is a line name antar ante transversal line antar. Now when two lines are intersected distant places by one transversal line, then eight angles are formed there. Eight angles are formed there. When two lines are intersected by a transversal line at distinct places, then eight angles are formed there. How many angles, Nana? Eight angles are formed there. That eight angles I will explain now. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See, it is one angle here, it is one angle here, it is one angle like this. Here 4, total 8. When two parallel lines are intersected by one transversal line, then 8 angles are formed. Then that 8 angles are, first one, interior angles. First one, interior angles. I-N-T-E-R-I-O-R, interior angles. Interior angles means, interior means inside. See, for this line, which are inside local angle line, Anna? 3, 4, 5, 6. That means angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are called interior angles. Interior angles are angle 3. Listen carefully, very important it is. Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6 are called interior angles. Next, exterior angles. Exterior means outside angles. E-X-T-E-R-I-O-R. Exterior angles. Exterior means which are outside. Which are outside, Nana? 1, 2, 7, 8 are called exterior angles. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, comma angle 8 are called exterior angles. Interior means inside angles. Exterior means outside angles. angles. The next, vertically opposite angles, third one. Vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles. Already we have learnt about vertically opposite angles. Which are vertically opposite to each other here? Angle 1 is opposite to angle 3. Angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. Next, angle 5 is opposite to angle 7. Angle 6 is opposite to angle 8. Then write. Here, vertically opposite angles are like pairs. Pairs means two two. Here write the vertically opposite angles, angle 1 comma angle 3. It is one pair, we have four pairs. Vertically opposite angles are four pairs. Angle 1 is opposite to angle 3. Angle 2 is opposite to angle 4. Next, angle 5 is opposite to angle 7. Angle 5 is opposite to angle 7. Next, angle 6 is opposite to angle 8. Angle 6 is opposite to angle 8. These are the vertically opposite angles. Vertically opposite angles are 4 pairs. That are 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6, 8. Next, corresponding angles. Fourth one, corresponding angles. C, O, R, R, O, S, P, O, N. D-I-N-G, corresponding angles. Corresponding angles are also four pairs. Corresponding angles means like this. One interior, one exterior. Angle 1 is corresponding to angle 5. Angle 4 is corresponding to angle 8. Angle 2 is corresponding to angle 6. Angle 3 is corresponding to angle 7. So write 1, 5, 2, 6, 4, 8. 3, 7. Then it is also four types. One is angle 1, comma angle 5 corresponding to each other. Angle 2, next angle 2, comma angle 6 is corresponding to each other. Next 1, 5, 2, 6. Exterior angle, interior angle. Exterior angle, interior angle. Here also interior, exterior, interior, exterior. 4, 8. Angle 4, comma angle 8. Next, angle 3, comma angle 7. Angle 3, comma angle 7. Vertically opposite angles and corresponding angles are 8 pairs. Sorry, 4 pairs. That means 8 angles. Next, alternate interior angles. Fifth one. Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles are 3 and 5 like this. And 4 and 6. Interior means inside. Inside alternate like opposite. Angle 3 and angle 5. That means like this. 3 and 5, 4 and 6. Alternate interior angles, only interior angles. Interior angles are 3, 4, 5, 6. In that interior, alternate like this. 3, 5, 4, 6. Alternate interior angles are 3, 5. Next, 2, 6. 3, 5. Sorry, 4, 6. Next, alternate exterior angles. Alternate exterior angles. Alternate exterior angles. Alternate exterior angles are same like interior, but we have to write exterior angles. Like angle 1 is opposite, angle 1 is alternate to angle 7, angle 2 is alternate to angle 8. That means 1, 7. Here also like pair. 1, 7, 2, 8. Next, seventh one. on the same side of the transversal. Interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Interior angles on the same side of transversal. TRANSVERSAL. Interior angles are same side of the transversal. Interior angles are same side of the transversal. 3, 6, 5, 4. 3, 6, 3, 6, 4, 5, angle 3, angle 6, angle 4, angle 5 are interior angles. Interior angles are same side of the transversal. Transversal ke oka vaipu unnadi. 3, 6 are one side, 4, 5 are another side. That means 3, 6 and 4, 5. Next, last, 8th one. So these are the 7 angles. 8th one is like some definition. About 8th angle I will explain in the next class. So we have to learn these angles compulsory. Transversal and above transversal lines. When two parallel lines are intersected by one line, and 8 angles are found there. That 8 angles are interior angles, exterior angles, vertically opposite angles, corresponding angles, alternate interior angles, alternate exterior angles, interior angles on the same side of the transversal. So these are the angles. Remaining about one angle. One angle gurinchi properties untayi kada, anduke explain cheyaledu. In the next class I will explain again. Okay children, if you have not understood this class, make call to me, ask me, I will explain again. Complete your homework up to here.